Yesterday, the Justice Reform Initiative released their report titled Alternatives to Incarceration in South Australia. The report argues that investment should be redirected into addressing the drivers of incarceration rather than investing in jails and imprisonment, particularly for young people. The report states, and I quote, "Prison does not work to reduce crime, it does not work to build safer communities, and it does not work to address the social drivers of contact with the criminal justice system. It has become an expensive, harmful and yet normalised failure which causes disproportionate harm to Aboriginal people who are significantly overrepresented in both the youth justice and adult prison systems." For young people in contact with the justice system, Mr President, the report calls for evidence-based, community-led programs to provide off-ramps out of the carceral system. The report contains a comprehensive list of evidence-based programs that have been proven to be effective as alternatives to jailing people. At the September meeting of the Standing Council of Attorneys General with regards to the minimum age of criminal responsibility, it was agreed that the committee would consider the report and return to the December meeting of the Standing Council of Attorneys General with a position or an update on the minimum age of criminal responsibility reform in their jurisdiction. It's our understanding that the December meeting will be held this Friday, that is the 1st of December. My question to the Attorney-General, therefore, is, will the Attorney-General, on behalf of the government, be advocating to raise the age of criminal responsibility at that meeting, and will the government finally commit to funding programs and alternatives to incarceration to keep young people out of prison?
Attorney-General.
I thank the honourable member for his question. He's indeed right. There is a meeting of Attorneys General due to take place in Canberra on Friday of this week that I will be attending on behalf of the South Australian Government. One of the items that has been a long-standing item on that agenda for the Standing Council of Attorneys General is the minimum age of criminal responsibility. We won't be announcing something in the lead-up to or in the near future after that. However, as the honourable member has asked a number of questions, and he has a very long-standing and a passionate and sincere interest in this area, work continues in a South Australian context. I've mentioned before that we are looking to see if the age was raised, what would come in its place. As I've said before in this place, one thing that we certainly won't be doing is just changing the number in a bit of legislation. The overriding aim that we will be focusing on is what makes the South Australian community safer. And certainly there are jurisdictions right around the world, in the UK, in Europe, in other places, in New Zealand, in Victoria, in the territories now, that have raised the age. And we are looking at the evidence about what makes the community safer. And yes, there is there is suggestions that by keeping particularly young people out of the criminal justice system, that can increase community safety. Yeah, one of the most telling factors about and being incarcerated as an adult is contact with the criminal justice system as a juvenile. How that is raised is certainly something that, if this is, and we have no commitment, we are doing the work to look at it. But if the age was raised, we'd need to look at one thing that other jurisdictions have looked at is what the age is raised to. I know many advocates advocate for raising the minimum age of criminal responsibility to 14. The jurisdictions that have moved in this space so far have started at 12 with an ambition or a stated desire to raise to 14. The other thing is, are there things that are exceptions or carve-outs? And that's something other jurisdictions have dealt with, and certainly in the work that we're doing in terms of what would come instead of a criminal justice response, those therapeutic responses, are things like the initial age, and whether there are exceptions is something we will consider.
The Honourable Mr Sims.
Will the Minister commit to giving an update to this House on that work when Parliament resumes in the new year?
Attorney.
Depending what state the work's up to, certainly.